interaction to discuss the challenges and opportunities that lies ahead. So without further delay, I would like to request Director Resident Instruction cum Dean Postgraduate Studies Barcelona for the orientation of Industry Institute Interaction. Sir, please.
Namaskar, everybody. Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Rameshwar Singh sir, Dr. J.K. Prasad, Dean Bihar Veterinary College, Patna, invited guest as well as eminent alumni Dr. Nilesh Prasad, Director Vitrogen Animal Health, Bangalore, and Dr. Naveen Kumar, Business Director, Dallas Asia Limited, Delhi, my fellow university officers, my fellow friend, Professor Deepak Patil, and Director Research and Dean PGS from Kamdhenu University, faculty members, guests, and my dear students. Dog does not cook rice is an old Chinese proverb. However, we need to talk to develop an ecosystem to teach how to grow and cook rice. Dogpreneur is one such venture in this tech-filled hyper-consumption age, energetic, compelling, sometimes poetic, yet inspiring events float around. In COVID pandemic, uncertainty envelops horizon. In such environments, a ray of hope floated by none other than our alumni leaders and infused dynamism among all students. One size does not fit all. Hence, a multi-layered, multi-transdisciplinary approach is required to imbibe values of entrepreneurship. Today, lecture will be delivered by two Bihar Veterinary College alumni, successfully entrepreneurs, Dr. Nilesh Prasad and Dr. Naveen Kumar. Topic to be covered by them are very pertinent and useful for career building of students. Being professional, our students should know about bright future in livestock industry. Sometimes it is very difficult for students to deal with uncertainty of job after fulfilling all education requirements. I am confident these lectures will be very fruitful for the participants. Last week, lectures of experts were well appraised to the participants, which tell the success story of our mission of industry-academia interface. I am quite confident that active participation of students in these lectures will be very beneficial and guidelines to make careers in right direction. In future, we will also try to organize such lectures on different aspects of career opportunities for the benefit of our students. I wish success of today's interaction. With these words, I would like to request to Dr. Archana for further proceeding. That's all. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your kind words, sir. Now, with the great honor and pleasure, I would like to request our Vice Chancellor, sir, to embellish this occasion with their words of blessings. Sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Archana. Dr. Veer Singh, Director Resident Instruction and Dean Postgraduate Studies, Dr. J.K. Prasad, Dean Bihar Veterinary College, esteemed and beloved speakers, Dr. Nilay Prasad and Dr. Naveen, both of you are very dear to us because you are our alumnus, and we have this kind of bondage and consider all our alumni as well-wishers of this university. We are trying to interact, connect with the alumni who, wherever they are placed, and they are a great source of inspiration for our students and our community and give us the kind of confidence when we see them doing very well or succeeding in different walks of life. It is the confidence that is gained by the entire system, not only the students, the young students. Throughout, through the entire, you know, fraternity, this gives a message. Yes, we don't have to depend on the government recruitment alone. There are several avenues. These avenues are multi, you know, very diverse and multifarious and different walks of life within the given sector, which is related to our core qualification. There are several, you know, branches. Several areas, several jobs and roles which can be done, right from laboratory to, you know, sales and, you know, formulations or other policies. So different kind of roles can be there. Apart from this, I always say that diversification may be altogether in different, you know, area from what your education has been. You have to succeed in life. You have to realize, or you have to move forward as the opportunity comes along. So these alumni are examples with us who have dared to, you know, chart a new course of life, which is different from the routine. And this gives us the kind of insights into how our graduates, other graduates, upcoming graduates, they can get the insights, they can get to know about these areas in a better manner and by listening to such stalwarts. So I welcome Dr. Nilay Prashad, Dr. Naveen, both of you. It's so nice of you to have agreed to speak to our fraternity here. And I always feel that this online opportunity has made it possible to organize more and more of such activities and to connect with more number of our alumni and our well-wishers. I wish the program a great success, and I see the participation is touching around 100. So a lot of interest is being generated in these on these topics. Already some programs have been held under this interaction itself. On 3rd October, we had two more speakers, and the session was very well received. So I hope today's session will also be very interesting, and a lot of information and interest will be created, as seen by the kind of questions which were asked by the participants. So I would request all the participants to put their questions in the chat box so that they can be compiled and they may be taken up at the end of the session. So all the best, and thanks to both the speakers. My greetings to all. Have a nice session ahead. Over to Archana. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. We are really fortunate to have your guidance and support with us, sir. Thank you so much. Moving forward towards our speakers. 18 years ago, yes, 18 years ago, he completed his graduation from Bihar Veterinary College in 2003. At that time, he has only this BVSc and AS degree in his hand and big dreams in his eyes. His conscious, deliberate and determined effort enabled him to master the skills of his field, and today the total brand value of products developed by him in Indian animal healthcare market in over 300 crores. Yes, you guessed it right. I am talking about Dr. Nilay Prashad. Dr. Nilay Prashad is a veterinary science professional with above 18 years of experience in the area of animal health care for both domestic and international animal health markets as well. Beginning his career as a business executive with Indo Biocare Private Limited, New Delhi, Dr. Nilay's portfolio included area business manager with Ranvaccine, New Delhi, product manager with Vetcare, Bangalore. Nowadays, this company named as Provimi Animal Nutrition. There, he was responsible for designing, marketing plan and branding strategy for all the three divisions, and then For his sincerity in work, he has been honored with Best Product Manager title in the company. Later, Dr. Prasad worked with R&D to develop an established lab animal nutritional product for several premier institutes in India, which include Serum Institute, Bharat Biotech, Biocon, and Indian Institute of Sciences, etc. Subsequently, Dr. Nilay Prasad got opportunity to work as a head of marketing team of 16 marketing professionals across India, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Vietnam, and Thailand. At present, Dr. Nilay is director of Vitogen Animal Health, Bangalore. This company has been recognized by Industry Outlook as among the top 10 animal health companies in India. He is also a founder and director of Aryan Vet Mumbai. He put his sweat, blood and soul to his Aryan company, which is recipient of Made in India Award for Best Product at World Trade Center in Mumbai 2016, and also awarded for the most innovative products at India Global Trade Show. It is an international show in 2017. We are honored to have you with us, Dr. Nilay. I welcome you again and invite you to enlighten our students with your professional skills. Over to Dr. Nilay.
Many thanks, Dr. Rajita, for this wonderful coordination of the entire meeting. Hope everyone is in best of health and doing great at workplace. In the beginning, I would like to extend my sincere thanks and regards to the Honorable Vice Chancellor. And in his words, I can see in his speech, I could make out some of the words which are so relevant in the industry in general. So honorable thanks and regards to the Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Rameshwar Singh ji, Dean Professor Veer Singh ji, Chairman Dr. J.P. Prasad, Organizing Secretary Dr. Pankaj, and Dr. Archana for coordinating this webinar. And above all, to the bright students of BVSC who have shown their interest to know more about the industry and entrepreneurship. I truly appreciate this effort to bring animal health industry and academics closer. It's a real pleasure being with all of you. I spent some of the most exciting days of my life at BVC. It was in the midst of so much of talent and energy that many times made me worry of being lost. I strive to match up the quick learning abilities of my colleagues, and on few occasions I could succeed as well, and that was really motivating and encouraging. I have really very good memories of very clear memories of the study lecture rooms, MLT hall. I used to sit mostly on the left rows. So, and I'm really glad that I got an opportunity to share something in the industry which doesn't catch the eye of a veterinary professional very quickly. But it's all on the curiosity. If you look what is happening all around the animal health industry, animal health sector, you will also find that industry is a very, very special branch of that. So before going on the topic of exciting avenues in animal health industry, I'll advise all of you, especially the students, to try understanding from within that what is your area of interest and why it is your area of interest. Ask yourself where you will like to pursue your career, into research, into teaching, into government official, into some civil services or any other career. Though we have many more excellent opportunities after veterinary science qualification, part of the industry gained popularity in the last 25 to 30 years very, very rapidly. Industry was not so acceptable of veterinarians during very early days. So that so I remember starting my career after BVSC. I just got an opportunity, and I read in a newspaper that there is an opening with a company called Indo Biocare, and they are looking for a salesperson. And I applied to that, and my interview was in Patna. I attended that interview and got selected to be in the Delhi headquarter. So that was the beginning of my career, and things started to move on from there. Later, when you are in sales and when you have the knowledge of veterinary science and you are dealing with the products which is closely related to your subject, you are already above other team members who don't have that kind of skills or qualification. So the chances of growth is always high. So, and in sales, you get a chance to meet around 3 to 4 people a day. And those are all practicing eminent veterinary professionals. So imagine interacting with these experts brings so much of experience. If you're meeting 100, 150 people in a month. Now, moving to that, I was thinking that the skill of veterinary sales can have a broader avenue, so which will be more suited for a veterinary professional. So I started to eye into product management, which is actually the core of the marketing in an animal health company or in most of the companies. So later on, I moved to vet care, and where I realized that this is something I wanted to do. This is something where I'll get maximum exposure to not only being in marketing, but also coordinating with different divisions of the company, like finance, like HR, like the logistics, many production, R&D. So that those gives you very good opportunity to learn in the beginning of your career. And when you learn it, then things started to work in your mind that how these can be applied. And you think of more of a practical application. And after the long journey of working with few eminent companies, I decided that I should be thinking of starting a new venture of my own. And the whole story started around 7 years back when I started Arion Vet, and which was specially dealing with companion animal health products. Later on, 5 years back, we started Vetogen Animal Health, and fortunately, we have a wonderful team of people. So we should be having this. The achievements and accolades are because of the wonderful team of people who you work with and who bring this to us. So I would like to share, because this topic is on exciting avenues of veterinary professionals, I like to give an outline of how is the industry and what are the opportunities and where we can take, where the career of a veterinarian can go, how far in this industry. So if you suggest, I'll try to put up a presentation, a short presentation. Dr. Pankaj, is it clear? Okay. So exciting avenues for veterinary professionals in animal health industry. Let's have an overview. What is happening recently? The current scenario. The industry overview says greater growth and increased opportunities. And why we say it now, it is very, very eminent now, because when you see the last GDP slided by almost 23%, the agriculture GDP was 3.4%, and the animal husbandry, which contributes about 26% of agricultural GDP. The overall animal husbandry has been estimated to have grown by over 7%. So the animal husbandry is an uplifting force to actually sustain the GDP at least up to the level of 3.4%. The only sector growing at a rate of 7% consistently for over 10 years. I'm not aware of any industry which has such a consistent and robust growth path. And if we have a look of the species-wise growth, at a CAGR of 8 to 10% during a forecast period of register a growth of 10% during a period of 18 to 23. And at present in 2020, the market size is expected to be around 75,000 crores. If you see species-wise growth rate, because the poultry market, which is heading steadily towards maturity, you'll see the dairy is nicely growing above 12%. The companion health, the fastest growing in the industry, is around 20%, and the others are around 8 to 10%. So overall, there is tremendous opportunity to drive the growth of animal health market in India. If you see the feed production species wise, you will see that there is a total production of almost 31 million metric tons of feed, where the poultry sector is almost around 78 to 80%, dairy is 14 to 16%, and aquaculture is around 4 to 5%. So if you, because we see these figures, because if you see poultry industry is one of the industry which is most organized at the production level and least organized at the marketing level. The dairy, however, you see is most organized, unorganized at the production level and very much organized at the marketing level. Aqua in both inland and shrimp. Our shrimp is getting a huge demand of exports. So that's the reason for a very robust growth in the aquaculture industry as well. Now, last week I saw this news insert in my newspaper. So because this is a gathering of alumni, let us see what other alumni are thinking about. So this is from IIM alumni, and they have come up with a huge dairy farm in Bangalore, which markets both cows and buffalo milk and named as Country Delight. So the IIM alumni are very much smart people. They really know where the industry, which industry is heading which way. So this is what they are doing. The largest dairy farm in Bangalore is run by IT professionals. So the indications are very, very clear that what a huge opportunity animal health sector holds. So because we have to talk about the role of veterinarian in the industry, how and where a veterinarian can fit into the animal health industry. See, it can, they can fit in the marketing, product management, or they can fit into technical specialization. They can start up with a sales, and they can also be a part of the research and development. So, talking about product management, what is product management? If you think from an industry standpoint, what is exactly product management? I have put a small clip saying that, which covers all the roles of a product management. Product management, people are looking for a visionary and a genius with attitude to implement. A person who should be both entrepreneur and corporate minded, and can work with people from all levels and cultures, and should be responsible for the financial success of the product. So this is like a superhuman being's job. So when you are set in the mid of that, and when you accept that role, the responsibilities are tremendous. The companies expect that you will be the driving force in this department. You will be the driving force of revenues for this department. You will drive the sales team of this department. You will equip the sales team with the technical skills, techno-commercial skills, to be more precise. And you will coordinate with various other divisions of the company to execute the overall goal of the company. So this is a very, very exciting role in the industry for a veterinarian. And specifically, when there is nowadays, when there is a degree of MBA, things get little easier for you. You will be reading in the books, and you will see practically those things happening in the industry. So you can correlate in a better manner, and the chances of success are really high. So let us see what these four specialties do in a company. Technical specialization, technical manager or head. This is an area where the knowledge and expertise of the person comes into picture, where the technical manager is considered to be the subject matter expert, and he serves as a mentor to sales and marketing team in terms of technical knowledge and information and the most recent updates. They also address some technical inquiries from customers regarding products and other offerings or services of the company. Above all, he also develops technical articles so that it can support the marketing content and take the purpose forward. Sales executive is just an entry level position. There are two ways. Nowadays, most of the veterinarians directly enter at the level of product executive, which is into a marketing role. It is not a sales role. It is into the marketing role because mostly the companies are recruiting nowadays directly at the product executive role. Earlier, during our times, the veterinarians were recruited at the level of mostly into the sales team. So the sales executive is responsible for demand and revenue generation, and they are the front warriors where the action is happening. They are the source of information for the company about market trends and what should be the next move. And they're obviously accountable for achieving the sales goals of the company. The R&D and product And R&D, the product trials, which are for field and lab. The role of R&D is into guiding and monitoring product testing, trials, and development. Keeping update of most recent advancement in technologies. It's a very, very challenging role within the company. Coordinating with educational institutions. Managing if a company has a farm, dairy, poultry, or lab animals, which I found in vet care. So companies like that, the R&D professional's role is really huge. So this was most about the roles in the industry. Let us have an overview of what entrepreneurship is actually, and what comes in our mind when we think about entrepreneurship. The biggest and the first thing which comes in our mind as an entrepreneur is failure. Because the data shows that success rate of startups is less than 10%. One person from IIM was telling that I'm getting too optimistic, it is less than 3%. So, and then we have to understand how to make it successful. It is always best to understand first what leads to failure. And also believe there is no failure which is permanent unless you give up. So if you see some of the very eminent reasons for failure of entrepreneurship is, I have marked some 8 points. It is not according to the market need. It's not according to market need means, and I have done this mistake many times in my life. If we have a wonderful technology, we, without understanding the market, we just make a beautiful presentation, packing and everything, and we take it to the market. So, and it is not need of the market. So over a period of time, no matter how hard we push, the product is not going to make its space in the market. So subsequently, such products over a long period of time fail. Improper financial planning. This is one of the keys for finance geniuses to say, but it's a huge topic to discuss upon, but financial planning is as important as anything else in the industry. Not the right team. The third reason of failure, it says not the right team. So not the right team means, as an entrepreneur, you can never be successful alone. You can be successful only with a wonderful team. And you should have the abilities to identify the best talents you have in the team, groom them properly, and build the team, give them a vision, a common vision. So those all factors help to achieve the company together. Got out-competed. So the competitors ran over you. So that's one of the reasons. The pricing and cost issues, this is another very big reason for a product or a solution to fail. Poor products, the quality of the product, of course, is a very obvious reason. Lack of a proper business model and not a very good marketing. So individually, we should be looking at all these factors which can lead to not a very good growth path. So we should be careful. And whenever we are making any decision in an organization, these things should be in our mind as an entrepreneur. We must think and brainstorm upon all these before making a decision. So here is something, what leaders do, how that success comes, what the leaders actually do. Leaders give shape to ideas. It means, and ideas How it comes? It comes from the curiosity. You have to be tremendously curious of what you are doing. And if you are curious, you will be having a very good observation of what is happening around in the industry. And then you have a background of the veterinary science and knowledge. So imagine, and you should be having, most importantly, the courage of what you have imagined and decided to apply that at the marketplace. So it demands a lot of passion and tremendous liking. You must have a lot of liking for that, because if you don't, when things will get tough in the industry, when things will get tough, you will be trying to, any individual will be trying to give up, because that is very normal. Remember that it's all teamwork. You should have ability to identify talents. You should be building the right environment where we should be heading. And you should be evaluating success. What are the parameters before I started? What are the parameters that I will be looking at over a period of time to determine the success or failure? And last is where it should be the next move. So it's a constant happening environment always in the company, where things change every day. So that's more about entrepreneurship and more about the ideas which I could understand while I became part of this industry. And now with these words, I would like to conclude my talk, and I'd like to hand over to Dr. Pankaj. If you have any, I'll be ready to take questions.
Really, it was very nice to hear you from beginning, and your story, your journey tells the story of success. If I am able to tell something, one quote: no failure is permanent unless you stop trying. And this is, I think, this is the motivation to keep on moving, not where we should be at all. And one more thing, you just narrated. What is your area of interest and why it is area of interest? I am sure our students, our participants must think upon these two lines. What is your area of interest and why it is? We have many things, many questions to ask. Connecting you after presentation of Dr. Naveen, because of you, our pride, I must say, our pride. And I must say at this point, Mila and Inki Patni, Dr. Mili, started journey. नैरेटिव की कहां से शुरुआत किया और कहां आए, तो आई एम श्योर कि हमारे स्टूडेंट्स आपसे बाद में भी इंटरेक्ट करेंगे, आपसे बहुत सारे सवाल पूछेंगे, बट इट इज हाई टाइम टू इनवाइट नवीन, डॉक्टर नवीन, हु इज जूनियर इमीडिएट जूनियर 95 बैच, बट फॉर नीले चलता रहूंगा पद पे तो चलने में माहिर बन जाऊंगा, चलता रहूंगा पथ पे तो चलने में माहिर बन जाऊंगा, या तो मंजिल मिल जाएगी या एक अच्छा मुसाफिर बन जाऊंगा या एक अच्छा मुसाफिर बन जाऊंगा। इसी के साथ डॉक्टर अर्चना, ग्रेट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डॉक्टर नवीन कुमार। अर्चना, आपकी आवाज म्यूट है।
थैंक यू सर, इट हैपेंस।
इतने बड़े लोग हैं तो थोड़ा
जी. नाउ इट्स टाइम टू मूव फॉरवर्ड फॉर आवर सेकंड स्पीकर. ड्रीम्स डज नॉट बिकम रियलिटी थ्रू मैजिक. इट टेक्स स्वेट, डिटर्मिनेशन एंड हार्ड वर्क. द मोस्ट एपिटोमाइज्ड एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस ट्रेट इज डॉक्टर नवीन कुमार. यस, Dr. Naveen Kumar, a bloomed and fragrant flower of this very soil of Bihar Veterinary College. Sir is an alumnus of BVC 95 batch, a postgraduate in international business from Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, IIFT, New Delhi, and master's in veterinary science from IVRI. He has experience of more than 18 years. In his professional journey, sir has held many responsible posts in several leading national and multinational companies like LG Life Sciences, Ranbaxy, Pfizer, Evitech Nutrition, and Suguna Pharmas, and there are many more. Presently, sir is associated with Best Asia Limited. It is a firm originated in USA. He manages a team of more than 30 employees comprising engineers and veterinarians in 12 different countries. Sir is not only a veterinary professional, but also a remarkable speaker. Over the years, sir has established a strong connection between the academia and the global pharma industry. It is my joy and privilege to welcome you, sir. I request you to motivate our students with your words of wisdom. Sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Archana. Thank you so much. Okay, so... No, great Nila. I gone through the Nila presentation. It was a great, you know. At the outset, before we start, I will first like to thank you, our very visionary Vice Chancellor, Dr. Singh. It's very fortunate for the students and for the university, like, you know, a new university like Basu, to have a visionary leader and visionary Vice Chancellor like Dr. Singh. It's very important, actually. In the beginning, you shape the, you know, the orientation of any career or any university, any organization. And we are very lucky that Dr. Singh is there. My thanks to and my greetings to DRI cum Dean PG, Dr. Professor Beer Singh. And also my humble greetings to Professor J.K. Prasad, Dean of BBC Patna. These organizing secretaries, I cannot tell, you know, but it's a privilege actually for me also. Organizing secretaries are like, you know, they are the pillars actually around which all this kind of session revolves. And I must thank you, Dr. Pankaj, Dr. Archana, for, you know, taking pain and, you know, extending and reaching out to your alumni. Cannot, you know, be more happy than this. I'm honestly, you know, cannot be more happy. I always wanted to speak, not because to our, you know, our colleagues and our dear, you know, graduates and pass outs and sometimes even vets, not only because that gives me some kind of, you know, feeling that I'm contributing, but also it gives me the feeling that I'm doing something for the profession. No, college से हम लोग निकल जाते हैं, बट कॉलेज हमसे नहीं निकल पाता है. आज भी व्हेनेवर आई ट्रैवल यू नो इन डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ कंट्री एंड पीपल, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन पीपल आस्क मी, व्हिच कॉलेज पास्ड आउट सर, एंड देन आई यू नो आई हैव टू से एंड यू हैव टू से दैट इट इज बिहार वेटनरी कॉलेज पटना. सो वी कैन कम आउट फ्रॉम द कॉलेजेस, बट कॉलेज नेवर गोज आउट, यूनिवर्सिटी नेवर गोज आउट, यू नो, फ्रॉम यू. दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ अ कॉलेज, दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ यू नो एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. आपके दिल से कभी ये कॉलेज नहीं निकलता. नीला वाज वेरी राइट इन सेइंग दैट वी हैव सो मच ऑफ यू नो फाउंड मेमोरीज ऑफ आवर कैंपस एंड वी आर जस्ट वन कॉल अवे एक्चुअली ऑनेस्टली यू नो फॉर आवर कॉलेज, फॉर आवर यूनिवर्सिटीज, फॉर आवर एकेडमिक वर्ल्ड. वी आर जस्ट वन कॉल अवे. द मोमेंट यू नो डॉक्टर पंकज टोल्ड मी दैट नवीन वी आर प्लानिंग टू डू समथिंग लाइक दिस एंड वी सेड वो वंडरफुल आइडिया, व्हाई डोंट यू इनवाइट डॉक्टर तनवीर ऑल्सो, व्हाई डोंट यू इनवाइट डॉक्टर आशीष मिश्रा ऑल्सो. आई सेड हिम यू नो थ्रोन हिम सो मेनी नेम्स. And you guys are really fortunate. This passing out, you know, batch, this graduate batch is really fortunate. You know, I was talking to Dr. Pankaj, organizing secretary, and, you know, sir, they are so fortunate. We used to hear so much about Dr. Tanveer Alam. You know, he was in the RVC and we wanted to we wanted to aspire to go into RVC, and you know, our seniors used to tell us that Dr. Tanveer Alam is already in RVC, and we used to think that, hey, how this guy must be looking like, how this guy must be, you know, I want to meet him, I want to hear from him. So many thanks to organizing secretary, many things, you know, thanks to this visionary leadership in the university sitting there. My heartiest thanks, guys. You guys are doing tremendous job. You guys are doing a fantastic job. We can speak in length, but let me first thing, you know, touch the first thing. This is not the right topic, actually, job uncertainty, because for a veterinarian, it can never be a situation like job uncertainty. But Dr. Pankaj wanted to put it, no, you must. I said that, oh, I will speak on uncertainty part, but he said on job uncertainty. And job uncertainty is certainly there. It plays in the mind of the fresh grads. I know that. It plays in the mind what to do now, how to do now. So I have only one slide actually for, only one slide presentation. Long back, you know, I used to work with Ranbaxy, sold its animal health business to ICICI Venture Fund. And I used to work with ICICI, you know, the Venture Fund board actually. So I had a chance, actually the whole marketing team got the chance to interact with Dr. K.V. Kamath, you know, Mr. K.V. Kamath once, he was the founder and chairman of ICICI Bank that time. So Mr. K.V. Kamath said, and we were very excited, we were young lads in the corporate, and we were very keen to present our work that look how we are doing, look how we are, you know, shaping the market, look how we are doing all this in the marketing world. And he was very humble and very nice, and he said us, that if you have a really good idea and if you have really done something, your presentation should not exceed more than 6 slides. You should be able to speak everything about your work, everything about your idea in 6 slides. But I have, you know, curtailed that parameter also. I have only one slide for my grades here, passing weights actually. And then he also actually, I remember one more thing actually, which he said me, that if you want to do anything in your corporate or in your personal life also, if you want to achieve anything, try, if it is an idea and if it is a conceived and if it is an achievable idea, you must deliver it within 90 days. You know, if you have a really working idea and which can be executed, it should be delivered, it should be executed within 90 days. And that I could see when I was working with ICICI Venture Fund President, Mrs. Renuka Ramanathan. You see all these, you know, all these big guys like Ms. Sikha Sharma, she was the director. She became the MD of Axis Bank. Chanda Kochar, she became the MD of ICICI Bank. Mrs. Renuka Ramanathan, she was then the MD of ICICI Venture Fund. And then later joined, started her own venture fund to buy and, you know, transact companies. It was the one guy who was mentoring all these three, you know, and I was very fortunate to have spent some time with, you know, legends like Mr. K.B. Kamath. Guys, it is very important to be the part and, you know, and have a mentor like as you are getting, you know, now, you know, in the term of leadership, in the professor position, in your organization, administrative positions like vice chancellor. It is very fortunate to have, and it is very important to learn things from them. Never to copy. I'm not saying to copy. I'm just saying learn from these, you know, these gems, these, you know, these successful persons. Read about them, go about them, follow them, and then probably you will realize that what is the human potential and what is your job uncertainty at this point of time you are thinking. It is nothing. But since you, Dr. Pankaj, wanted me to cover the chapter of job uncertainty, I have one slide which I will come, and from there probably I will speak my mind. No.
Screen share.
Can I share the screen? Yeah, please. Can you help
me? It on.
I wanted to share my screen. Can I do that?
Yeah. Just down. Lowest side.
Do I need to download it?
No. Just you need.
Oh, there is an option, sir. Share screen.
Yeah, I clicked that share, okay, but I could not see that. Okay, just a second. Yeah.
Sir, first you have to open the slide on desktop.
Okay, yep, done. That I was not aware, that I'm aware. Okay.
Now, Vets.
Okay, so, my dear Vets, you are going to be now the flag bearer for this university. You are going to be now the flag bearer of your college. So what's now, Vets, is my question to you. What are you planning? What are you thinking? Probably a lot of things actually is going in your mind currently. Which sector? Government sector, private sector? What to do? Start a business? You know, go for the job search? Go for some further study? Some people are even planning, they have the luxury to plan a marriage also, go for a marriage. I don't know, but this is something very crucial actually, juncture you are sitting on when you have a thing and you have to juggle a lot of things, a lot of questions in your mind. I don't know that these are unwanted questions or these are wanted questions, but these are the questions it must be going on in your mind. So if you're looking for a job, this is a crucial time. Mind it, guys. Don't think that this job search will be easy one and this job search will be, because you are not an unemployed guy. You guys are, you know, Vets are never, I'm telling you, Vets are never fall off any opportunity. You plan, you can dream and you can achieve it. All I can tell you at this point of time. But if you are looking after for a job at this point of time, be sure, find your strength, be sure to put your feet in the right place, then stand firm. And that is the, you know, that is the mantra of success. Wherever you want to go into the government sector, you want to go into the private sector, be sure what you want and put your feet in the right place. That's all. And then after putting the right, you know, feet in your right place, then you have to simply show your courage to achieve whatever actually you wanted to achieve from your career path, from your life, from your professional life. So if you are looking for a job, this is a really crucial time. And if you are looking for a job, don't think that only you are looking at the job. Even the job employers, they are also looking at it. This is my only one slide for you guys. Find the right fit. And don't only think from your own perspective. It is all about the matter of perspective. Since now I have spent some 18 years in this corporate world, in the private world, I will talk little more towards the private world, you know, job opportunities and job challenges. And I will not be touching much because you have a lot of mentors. You have a lot of your own seniors there advising you on the government jobs and the academic jobs. I will be more be from the private world, the corporate world. Don't only think that you are looking at the job, you are searching the job. Even job giver is also looking at you. We are also watching you very, very carefully. Who is the guy who is going to contribute? Who is the guy who is going to take my organization to the next level? Unless this fit is not achieved, I'm telling you, this job search is like a very daring thing. Very daring thing. This job search is could be, you know, painful. And in the Western world, they say that don't screw up things, man. Don't screw up, really, I'm telling you. Find your feet. Don't get motivated by Dr. Tanbir Alam. Don't simply get, you know, don't try to be a copycat, all I mean to say that. Don't look at my life. Don't look at Dr. Nilay's life. Don't look at, you know, someone's in the, you know, the sitting in your vice chancellor's life, your professor's life. First, look at your own strength. First, look at your own skill set. And then plan here. What is the one thing which you have been doing the best? What is the one thing for which you are known into the in the campus? What is the one thing for which your professors will remember you? What is the one thing which your family says that this guy is too good in this? Find that skill, pack that skill nicely, and then post it to the job giver and the employers. Until and unless, I'm telling you, you are not aware of your own strength, probably you will not be able to enjoy this whole professional journey. I don't know whether you guys are aware about this. you know, that there are two kind of career. One is the, you know, the professional journey. We call it a professional journey. And there is a called the professional destination. Professional destination and a journey is a different thing. Journey is something like you want to keep on growing, keep on learning new things. You want to enjoy life from different perspectives. You don't want to enjoy only life from the one field. You also want to look at the adjacent field. You also want to open up and see things which is not into your own core area, into your own core veterinary science. You try to look at around and then you try to work with those perspectives. That is called the journey. You started as a vet and you reached somewhere which is, you know, completely unlinked with your veterinary science. That is the journey. And the career destination is professional destination is like that. You wanted to achieve some proficiency at certain level and you wanted to go that. Probably the government jobs are like, they are more like a destination. You wanted to be in a government job. You wanted to be a professor. You wanted to be a scientist in this role and in that role. And that is called the destination. You for that, you need to bring in certain level of proficiency and then you go into and invest your time and life into it. And this private life is all about the professional journey. It never settles. It goes from one wings to another wing to another tree sometimes completely unrelated. Last time I heard Dr. Madhav, you know, who is working with this Rickett Bagginser, and I heard his things. He was saying that whether you are a vet, you are a no vet, doesn't matter. If you are a graduate from FMS, you will get absorbed into any corporate world, any companies. And then you will be given a job and then you will be given a role and you will start, striving. And you're striving, in the corporate world, there's the beautiful saying, which we call it that corporate has only one mantra: learn, unlearn, and relearn. There is nothing which is called here that, you have learned it, now don't forget it. It is every day you have to practice this mantra. So you have to find your own strength. You have to find your own talent. Bring in all together. Don't try to be a copycat. Don't look at Dr. Nilay's success, Dr. Tanvir's success, Dr. Madhav's success. Bring in all your strength, your talents, your educational backgrounds, your degrees, your feedback from your professors, from your teachers, from your friends. Bring it on the table, sort it out nicely, and then find the right fit, which way to go for. Suppose that you get inspired. You don't have the skill set, but you get inspired to achieve or to follow the path of someone XYZ. What happens? You will try, but because you don't have the skill set, so what happens that you will fail a couple of times and then probably you will settle for an average, average human being, thinking that, hey, this is not my cup of tea. All I am telling you, this is a fantastic time for you to analyze yourself. What is it which you as a resource, as a human resource, bring to the table, to a corporate world, to the government world, to a research world, or anywhere else? What is that brings you? What is it which makes you different? And now the difference things, probably, I tell you from my own journey experience. When I came out from graduate, in 2000, I left this campus in 2000. I landed in IVRI after IVRI doing my master. I didn't know anything. Everyone was looking for the professor job and, they wanted to pursue their career in academic world. They wanted to become professors. And I also actually started pursuing the same thing. I reached Pantnagar. Pantnagar, gave me some, teaching associate kind of job in the department of surgery. And then I started, teaching people about the surgery. And it was the time when I was unaware about my own strength completely. I was not aware about my own thing, that what do I like? I was thinking that, hey, I'm a vet, I'm a surgeon now, I need to do this only, that's all. But when I came out, you know, it was the month of September when LG Life Sciences picked me from the campus of Pantnagar. I joined LG Life Sciences. I started working with the corporate, best of the corporate minds. I got exposed to, you know, different countries and different practices. Then probably I could realize, hey, this is one of the fantastic jobs which I can deliver, which I can do as a surgeon. Can you imagine after, you know, doing my surgeon master and after doing my 5 years of work in corporate world, I chosen, you know, to pursue my international business master degree from IFT. Because I found a fit that, my dear friend, I am a good fit for the international business. I'm a good fit for this dynamic business environment. It was the year, I'm telling you, it was the year, you know, when I became almost like, you know, 39, 40 years, I enrolled myself to IGNOU because I wanted to understand people's perspective to do my master in psychology. I completed my, because I wanted to understand why this customer is thinking, why this country person is thinking like this. It is very important to understand others' perspective. If you are only a vet and I'm an employer, probably I will also look for a fit that whether this guy is employable or not. This is a fantastic, crucial time to plan not only, suppose you all are not going to get into the job mode, what you will do? Plan. This is the time, crucial time to plan. You know, you want to work on your communication skills. Okay, you wanted to go always into the research field. I should go for the higher studies. I always wanted to go into the government sector because I wanted to do this and I have the limited affordability to sustain for longer study time. All these things. So this is a very crucial time and very important time in your life. And don't only get motivated, you also not be very copycat. I have seen so many uninterested mind and demotivated mind working in different government professionals because they came into the field because they wanted a job. Time is now, actually. This is the time when you will shape your whole professional journey or your whole professional destination. This uncertainty, sometimes I used to actually talk in the sales team and I used to always say, my sales team will come and say that, boss, this is too high a target, too high a budget we have taken. This will put us on stress. And I always will say that a little stress is a good deal, that will keep us focused, that will keep us entrenched into our work. It is very important to have a little stress. Do you guys remember when, you know, there is exam, how we will study the whole book bloody in one day? And when, you know, for whole semester, 1-6 months will go by and we will not even, you know, finish up the first chapter. That is the power of little uncertainty. That is the power of little stress. I guess, you know, you guys are above average, you know, you guys are above average. And for average person, I'm telling you, or above average person, uncertainty is always like a strength. It brings you over the biggest, you know, or you are, I will say, the strongest foot ahead. For an average person, like, you know, a vet or an MBBS, you know, who is parallel to MBBS, you guys are going to, I'm telling you, from here to fly, you know, unlimited. Limit is, the sky is going to be the limit. But then you have to plan your whole skill set, whole your characters, whole your aptitude, you know, nicely. And not only for you, I will also request the visionary team sitting over there. You know, make it a process so that these guys get continuous feedback. They get continuous revert from the, you know, the corporate world. They can see what is, you know, to pick from. If they will not see multiple choices, they will only be choosing one or two out of one or two options. Hey, I need to go into this because I have to know other choice. I've done master, now I've done PhD, now I have to get into the college and be the professor. Because you don't have seen the, you know, your exposure is so limited. you meet all now the USA's, you know, these corporate workers, they are all are PhD and MBA. It was the time, you know, 10, 15 years back when I used to see this, the Americans, they were all DVM and MBA. After 10 years now, it's completely changed. It's all PhD and MBA. So I started realizing what happened, what, you know, why everyone is going for PhD and then finding into the MBA. Same answer which I used to presume this should be, if you are a technical person, why to confine in a laboratory? Why not test the, you know, this, kiss this world, go around and, you know, talk, sell your concept. So don't actually, I will say, get exposed to as many people. This kind of exposure, I'm telling you, unbelievable from, you know, the BVC and from Basu. 20 years back, we have seen how, you know, I'm the one flock. I came in, you know, search of job, you know, got into colleges, you know, started teaching, you know, somehow picked up by the corporate and realized that, hey, this guy, this sector has a lot of opportunity and this sector has a lot of, financial stability to bring in. I don't need to work for 60 years. If I can, you know, stabilize myself in 45 years, fantastic. I will do on my own things. You know, I tell you, when I shifted in 2002, I came to Delhi. After spending five and a half years in veterinary and 2 years in master in surgery, 6 months in Pantnagar as a teaching associate, I never wanted to leave my veterinary field. I was paid that time hardly, you know, 30,000. I spent 5,000. I started my own small clinic. Today, that clinic is, I'm not able to sit, I'm not able to give, but at least I'm giving opportunity for young vets. There are 2 vets, 3 attendants are working in that clinic. I feel pride that I'm not get, you know, I used to see those, you know, veterinarians came into the corporate world. They are not actually injecting their own animals. They are, you know, they don't know how to, what happened. And I used to think that I'm not going to be after 45 years. If I come out of from, you know, my corporate world, I will start being actually, you know, doing the same thing which I love. Even this is the one of the noblest profession. But only it is a noblest when the service is in your mind. When you want to earn money, when your career is all about the materialistic measurement, you have to look for then where the financial stability lies, how soon it lies, how soon I can get it. These are many questions you need to answer, but that chapter will open very slowly. At the time being, this is a crucial time. Find your skills, make it fit with the organization which you are going to work. Employers should also jump over you. And once the employer jumps over you, they don't look at the compensation and remuneration. If I see a fit, if I see a, you know, the value in my company, in my organization through you, no, there's no, I'm telling you, there's no dearth of paying remuneration, which is unseen. So all I will say that first, there should be no, hey, this uncertainty thing. I think it is the biggest dilemma the human, you know, the species face on this world. Uncertainty, the fear factor. But all I can tell you, the biggest dilemma also helps you to open up it helps you to open up, you know, the boundaries, new boundary, take your new chances. All are waiting for you. There are so many, I do not want to bring in the job uncertainty. You guys are destined to work as a girl state officer in the government of India. Even if you keep on pursuing your educational academic, you know, world only. If it is up to you, if you really want to explore the world, if you really want to kiss around the world, if you really want to travel, if you really want to influence people, so know your mettle, that what you are made of, then this private sector, corporate world, or, you know, I think, you know, my batchmate right next to me became the civil servant. It's important that what is your skill set, what is your aspiration? Don't try to be a copycat. After 3 years, you all will be settled. But point is that on which path? At what place you have put your feet very firmly? And then after putting your feet, the courage things comes, which Dr. Nilay was talking. Success, you know, the fear factor in the startup. I think courage is the courage, you know, the fearlessness, the courage thing is the biggest, you know, of all virtues. If you have the courage, you can, you know, help all your virtues to grow. If you don't have courage, probably any other virtues will also not help you. So all your skill sets should get backed up by this courage things. You must be, you know, courageous to take chances, to dream bigger. You are already in the safest profession of the, I will say, in India. Now government is going to pay you some, you know, scholarship to study in that. Can you imagine a course where government is going to pay you some $3,000 to study? You are in the safest course, but it is about not about the being the safest and being the most, you know, secured person. It is all about exploring. If your nature is exploration, if your nature is to really go, you know, around and, you know, learn from things, learn different perspectives, learn not only veterinary, learn adjacent field. I have a lot of interaction with Dr. Pankaj. I'm sorry if I'm exceeding. I have a lot of, you know, interaction with Dr. Pankaj. I have completely changed my field from a surgeon to a now an engineer. I'm more like a feed technologist. So it's all about, and today I boast, you know, today I go and I teach Chinese, I teach Malaysians, I teach Vietnamese about the feed technology, how we are doing. It's all important if you want to go all around and see the world, enjoy this world, and achieve as sooner as financial stability. Probably you need to be a little courageous. Find you, but the first thing and the last thing is to find the right fit. As an employer, we are also watching you. As an employer, we interview so many and we are looking at you that whether this guy brings in some value to us, whether this guy will be a, you know, gross fit to our organization to take it to the next level. So guys, this is something I will say, and very important and last paragraph of my whole thought process. It is very important actually for the professors there also, you know. In year 2008, I wanted to quit the job and I wanted to start my own institution because I used to feel that when I'm interviewing people, there is very less employability skills. I don't know if Dr. Nilay remembers it or not, but I have at least, you know, guided 10 vets how to start. You know, they all were into struggling into the sales, you know, job. And I used to guide them that, hey, get into the marketing. That is the best avenue for a veterinarian. A veterinarian with a sales experience into the marketing, I'm telling you, that is a recipe for a very good successful entrepreneur or very good business leader. Because all a veterinarian all lack at this point of time is a sales exposure. Sales is all about a lot of tactics and tricks in the market. So if you have an experience, don't think that if you have to come into the corporate world, I will not go into the sales because that hurts my ego. Hey, look at the Bollywood actors. They struggle for 10 years as a co, you know, and the behind the scene worker. And once they become star, people chase them. It's all about finding your skills and aspiration, and then back it up with your courage. It's very important for the teachers, mentors there also. And because the vice chancellor, dean, and DRI come, Dean PG is sitting over there, I will request them to, sir, form an industry desk. We don't actually, if we have 20 people in the industry, we can always conduct. Look at the IVRI, they conduct, look at the NDRI. Last, you know, year, NDRI invited me in their nutritionist winter school skill to talk on the feed technology and feed processing. If we can form an industry desk where people can come in and the guys who are interested in private and the corporate world and interactions happens regularly, not many people would be courageous enough to get plunged into this corporate and the private world. This has a lot of uncertainty. This needs a lot of, you know, skill set. That's why I'm saying that you need to, you know, align all your skills. So these professors have a lot of role to mentor them. You know, mentoring is now the new word actually, where young executives, even in the corporate world, young executives who have a lot of potential or high potential, they are being attached to the chief executive office. And they will see the chief executive working, how he is leading, how his routine goes like, how he is working. And then this mentoring is a culture. So I guess that going forward, once we have achieved this first initial ice is broken, I will suggest that, you know, university should must establish industry days. Call up your industry from your own alumni. They will never say no. They will come to you, and they all are at the good position. They all bring, you know, different perspectives from the different, you know, fields. And if you can really form it, I will say organized interaction, it will help at least 10% of those guys in those, you know, MLT backbenchers or the front benchers who aspire for, you know, the career in corporate and industry or, you know, startup venture. It will certainly help at least 10-20% of people, and that will be a good, I will say, portfolio for a university to have 20% or 10% of their students alumni in the industry. And that will completely change the outlook of our university, our college. With all this world, I really thank you. I wanted to speak. I never actually tried to stop myself. I wanted to speak my heart out to you guys, because it is a very rare occasion, and it is really a crucial time for you guys to decide on how to move forward. Thank you very much, Dr. Pankaj. Thank you very much, Dr. Archana. We can take the questions. I'm very happy. I must acknowledge. I'm very happy. Someone from the Pantanagar has also joined us, and he is, you know, writing that I'm Mohit Bhardwaj. I'm very happy. This kind of session can, I'm telling you, change the outlook of the university and colleges. Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you for, you know, having a very patient, giving a patient hearing to me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for such a mesmerizing talk.
Thank you.
And I'm sure a student must have soaked a lot to take back from this session. Thank you so much, sir.
And
now for the further questionnaire and discussion session, I request coordinator HRD cell Basu, Dr. Pankaj Singh, sir, to carry forward the program. Over to Pankaj, sir.
Thank you, Archana. And first of all, thank you very much, Naveen. Dear Naveen, for encouraging our students, your alumni, our students, and our future. And if I put you two or three words, look at your strength, look at your strength, and look at your strength. This is the core things our students must learn, must just like mantra. And one more thing you have to say, be sure you put foot in the right place and then stand firm. जहां है कम से कम वहां तो अच्छे से खड़े हो और डोंट ट्राई टू बी अ कॉपीकैट. आई थिंक दीज वर्ड्स विल हेल्प आवर स्टूडेंट टू मूव अहेड टू कैरी देयर कैरियर इन राइट डायरेक्शन. और बहुत सारी बातें हैं, बट जस्ट टू ईज आवर स्टूडेंट्स आई मस्ट से एक जो जैसे अब इन्होंने जर्नी बताया कि कहां से शुरू किया मास्टर डिग्री. रिगार्डिंग स्ट्रगल मैं थोड़ा सा समय लूंगा, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर और डीन पीजी सब डीन साहब थे कि जब नवीन यहां से पास आउट हो रहे थे तो आप सभी भी जब फाइनल ईयर में जाएंगे तो बिहार वेटनरी काउंसिल से आपको 6 मंथ पहले एक नवीन
यप 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 प्लीज प्लीज गो अहेड या प्लीज गो
तो 6 मंथ पहले आपको एक टेम्पररी रजिस्ट्रेशन करवाना होता है बिहार वेटनरी काउंसिल. Being, पता नहीं कहां व्यस्त थे नहीं थे, सबने करवा लिया 99 स्टूडेंट्स में से किसने नहीं करवाया था. और बाद में ऐसा हुआ कि बिहार वेटनरी काउंसिल ने इनको रजिस्ट्रेशन देने में दिक्कत कर दी. मैं अभी एक वर्ड यूज करना चाहता हूं कि लोग कहते हैं ना कि स्कार्सिटी को कैसे अपॉर्चुनिटी में बदलते हैं. अभी मैं कुछ बच्चों का कल ही फेसबुक देख रहा था फाइनल ईयर के राना और सबका कि वो अभी किसी एक डेयरी सेक्टर में जा रहे हैं और वहाँ ट्रीटमेंट कर रहे हैं, कोई गायनेकोलॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम हैंडल कर रहा है. तो हाउ ही स्टार्टेड, और जब पहली बार इससे मिला था आईवीआरआई में रूम में, बोला कि बॉस एलजी वाले कोई प्रोग्राम कर रहे हैं. बोला एलजी तो टीवी बनाती है, फ्रीज बनाती है, बट देन आई केम टू नो कि नहीं हार्मोन भी बनाती है. तो हाउ ही स्टार्टेड हिज जर्नी एंड हाउ सक्सेसफुल ही इज, आई एम श्योर आवर स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट बी मोटिवेटेड बाय हिज थॉट, बाय हिज लर्निंग स्किल. और बीच में कुछ दिन पहले आए थे, ले गए थे फतवा कि जहां पे ये इंजीनियरिंग का काम कर रहे थे. सो हैट्स ऑफ टू यू कि बहुत सारे एवेन्यूज को आप टैकल करते हैं. और जैसे अभी कहा आपने कि ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर सर, हमारी पूरी अथॉरिटी इस चीज का ख्याल रख रही है आज के दिनों में कि हम एलुमनाई से वेल कनेक्टेड हों और आपके हेल्प से, आपके सहयोग से हमारे स्टूडेंट्स का जो एक कैरियर हो
हम
जहां कहीं भी मौका मिले आप अपने एलुमनाई को जरूर टेकल करिए, जैसे बहुत सारे कैंपस में एलुमनाई आते हैं, बहुत
सारे अपने लोग
हमारे यहां ऐसा बहुत कम देखते हैं। हमारे इतने सक्सेसफुल एलुमनाई है, रिक्वेस्ट करते हैं कि वो कैंपस में आए, हमारे बच्चों के हमारे स्टूडेंट्स के स्ट्रेंथ को पहचाने, उन्हें नरिश करें, फिर उस लेवल तक ले। थैंक यू वेरी मच नवीन एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच नीले फॉर योर एडमायरिंग एंड इंस्पायरिंग लेक्चर, रेदर आई कैन से डिस्कशन। नॉट बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस है बच्चे जानना चाह रहे हैं, बच्चे मींस माय स्टूडेंट्स, मैं एक एक करके शुरुआत। प्लीज म्यूट, एक एक करके सवाल पूछता हूँ जो स्टूडेंट्स ने पूछे है। फर्स्ट थिंग इज पीयूष रंजन, हाउ टू लॉन्च द प्रोडक्ट इन द मार्केट, सम स्ट्रेटजी टू गेट लीड्स फॉर इट। आई थिंक दोनों प्रोडक्ट मैनेजर हैं, आई थिंक मोर देन प्रोडक्ट मैनेजर, हाउ टू लॉन्च प्रोडक्ट ये आप जानते हैं, अगर इनको अगर कुछ बताना चाहें नीला या नवीन।
Hello, Dr. Naveen. So, Dr. Naveen, shall I? Hello. I think Dr. Naveen is on mute. So, your question is how to launch a product.
Yeah. Go ahead, Neela. You can take it, man.
How to launch a product? It's a very, very big question. First, in the beginning, you have to ask yourself, why do you want to launch that product? Why? What are the opportunities? You have to do a market research and understand that what are the opportunities of this product in short term and long term. So, and in which sector you want to launch that product. Then you'll have to look into what kind of marketing programs you'll have when you plan to launch this product. Also, you'll have to look into a lot of financial aspects of how much investment is going to be pumped in and what revenues based on your market research and the trends you are expecting this product when it goes into the market, in how much time you can see what you call the break even or the revenue started to come in. And before that, you'll also have to calculate that what will be the gross margin of the product, what will be the net margin of the product, will this product be useful for you in the coming years. So you will have to do a very, very thorough brainstorming understanding. You have to coordinate with the technical teams, and you'll have to coordinate with R&D whether this product can actually be formulated or it is just the formula is in my mind, whether it can become real or not. So those are the things that we'll have to always wisely consider. And in today's world, when we are surrounded by so much of information, sometimes I feel that whether we were lucky during those times or we are not lucky during this time, because today you have to say no to more things than you have to say yes. What you have to see is because before reading also, your mobile phone or laptop is flooded with so many informations. So what you have to read, if you are reading something useless, don't do that. So that's your instinct where you should go and how much you should be reading. And if you are confident at the end that, okay, this is my idea and you have a right business model, and I see that the product will be good, and maybe in future we can have an extension of that brand. So 100 questions. So if you finally agree on all those points, go ahead and launch. And above all, if the product doesn't do good, don't be disappointed. The last message I would like to say, try next thing.
Great. Yeah. I will just add one line. To launch a product, you know, there are two aspects. One is the regulatory aspects. You cannot launch any product, particularly the pharmaceutical product, without regulatory approval and registration with the DCGI. What Nila mostly talked about, the marketing and the sales challenges and the business challenges aspect. The regulatory aspect is a very important angle when you can get this formulation approved. Suppose you, he said very rightly that if something you have in the mind, but you cannot formulate it, and government regulatory bodies, drug controller, they do not find it that this is suitable or this is safe or this is, you know, safe for the environment and the end consumer, then it is very difficult. So both the angles you have to look at it. Marketing suitability is one thing and regulatory suitability is another point of. Yeah, please go ahead, sir, with the next question.
Thank you. Thank you, Naveen. And one question is doing MBA after graduation will be better or have first MBA first and then go for a job? Pahle MBA ya job ya pahle job ya fir MBA. If anybody
Nila, I take this question. Huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Please. See, last time, you know, I attended both those lecture from Dr. Madhav and Dr. Tanveer. It doesn't need, you know, to be MBA or VET or VET or MBA. It is you who has to. I'm telling you, my only slide is that make your own feet. You know, employer is also watching you very closely. Employer is looking at you that what values you are going to bring in. If I, as an organization, I need to bring you in my company and I need to train you on marketing and the sales aspects for 2 years or 1.5 years, then my return will start coming only after, you know, 3 years. So point is that if you go with the MBA, it adds value to your portfolio, it adds value to your resume. But don't get, you know, if you have something which you think that you can really impress the employer, which with which you can, with your conviction, you can really bring in, you know, the interview board that, look, I have something, I don't need MBA. I have an, you know, better experience. Suppose that what if you have done, you know, you are in Bihar Veterinary College. Suppose you were a graduate from USA, you know. USA graduates earns how much, you know, by doing, you know, extra hours working in the market. Out of 100,000, you know, fees of normal university in USA, people are earning, you know, they themselves work in different outlets, they themselves work out, you know, they are on in the spare hours for, and they earn almost 70,000. So 70% they are funding their own studies. We all, you know, I remember last time, you know, there were questions, can I go to foreign and can I go? And why, you know, why we cannot go to foreign land? Why we cannot go and practice? Why we cannot go and study there? But it's important to be entrepreneurial. You know, these guys like in USA, in Canada, they are very entrepreneurial. Their entrepreneurship is excellent. They are working, you know, they are working when they are studying. And probably that opens a very new, very good avenues for them how to make money also. And you know that skill, that experience they bring into the organization. Organization sees that, hey, come on, this guy is already working in this company for 6 months as a part-time employee. This guy must have a certain level of skilled communication, certain level of exposure. So he is most welcome to my organization also. He will certainly contribute. That kind of, you know, the alignment is important. It doesn't matter MBA. Or but as a professional standards, we people like, you know, in corporate world like me and like Dr. Nile, sometimes we have started seeing a formulation like an MBA plus VET or MBA plus master is giving us better results. Okay, go for this formulation. It is something like same that your, you know, pantoprazole is giving you right result or alone, or it is, you know, in combination with domperidone. Which is better, Pantop D or Pantop? Yeah, I see that this MBA is, you know, better with VET, or this VET is better with, you know, the MBA. So now the industry has made a standard that if you are an MBA, we presume that you have a certain level of skills with you. You are bringing values to the organization. And I told you in the beginning in my lecture that there is no dearth of paying you remuneration. Because people do not mind paying you, so why they will pay you, you know, some, you know, 20,000 or 50,000 less salary? They will pay you higher, but they will hire a better combination. Am I right, Dr. Nile?
Yeah. Very, very well explained, Dr.
Thank
Naveen.
Thank you.
Thank you, both of you. And the same question is from Roop Narayan. I think Rugnan must have got the answer. And I think I must say this is a private question, a personal question. Namrata has asked, what is your biggest strength? Just reveal it. And what she wants to ask you, कि कौन सी ऐसी आपकी strength है जो आपको बिहार वेटनरी कॉलेज के उस जमाने से आपको इसको चाहिए तक ले आया? Be honest.
So, Dr. Naveen, you would like to go, or shall I start? Or both of us should say.
Nilay?
Shall I?
Like good speakers.
So, I'll tell you, when you talk about here, कि ऐसी क्या चीज है जो कॉलेज से लेकर के यहाँ तक आया एंड दैट वाज माय स्ट्रेंथ. आई लाइक टू से डॉक्टर नवीन आल्सो विल अग्री टू दैट एंड बिकॉज़ वी बोथ वेर कनेक्टेड टू सम स्पोर्ट्स आल्सो इन द बिगनिंग. सो व्हेन यू प्ले एनी स्पोर्ट्स और यू स्ट्राइव टू विन एंड देन यू आल्सो गेट अ टेस्ट ऑफ फेलियर. सो स्पोर्ट्स वन ऑफ द एरियाज दैट टीचेस यू that once you fail, you take it in what sense you have to take it, so that again you go and play with the same zeal and same enthusiasm. That's the inside strength which I feel that people say that you if you fail, what will happen if you fail? So if someone says that you have a degree, I say, yeah, I have a degree. I have a PhD in failure. So I have tried many things. I failed and again tried and at one point of time, you will succeed. So that's about the part of strength. But today, if you ask me where that strength has led me to, today my strength is more into foreseeing visualizing where the market is going, managing the team of people which we have within the organization, giving them vision, building the right team together so that they work and take the company to next level. So those are the management aspects that now I feel has become one of my strengths.
Dr. Nilay was an excellent team, I will say player, and his strength of the same, you know, like team player, visualizing the, you know, where the match is going, you know, he used to visualize very nicely where the match is going, which teammate is going to, you know, contribute. So these are the, you know, participative strength. The team is a strength, or I will say working in a team is a very first requisite in entering into a corporate and private world. You are in the private world, you are not going to work alone. In your own practice, probably you can manage working with your own talent, but in a team, in an organization, you cannot work alone. You need to take your team along. And I think Dr. Nilay is very right. He used to be very good during the, you know, those cricket matches also, in, you know, finding strength and visualizing where the match is moving, strategizing things. And I will suggest, in nutshell, it was the participative, you know, work. We participated a lot, good or bad, I will not say, but we participated together in a lot of, you know, ventures, right? So participative and academia. See, I'm telling you, we had a wonderful academic, you know, environment. We had a lot of very nice teachers. See, if you could really get, you know, closer with one or two good, three, four good teachers of your interest, probably you will learn a lot. So academic thing was very good. You know, with me particularly, I was very good in academic and I always wanted to pursue that. Even after doing my, you know, even in, you know, you go to the, you know, after, you know, qualifying in my MBA, and, you know, the interview board is asking you why you want as a doctor after you now, you know, doing 5 years of job, you want to work here. It's a, you know, it is important that you keep on. I want to augment. I want to go for the next level. You know, that is how actually you work in the private sector. Otherwise, you will not be able to go up the ladder, climb up the ladder. So it's very important that you be participative, play in the team, and then, you know, have the courage to win, actually go ahead, you know, compete with each other. That is a wonderful thing we learned from veterinary college.
Thank you, Naveen. This means we have courage to lead. Well said. अच्छा याद आ रहा है, जब हौसला बना लिया ऊंची उड़ान का फिर क्या देखना ऊंचाई आसमान
का। करेक्ट सर।
एंड आई थिंक देयर आर मेनी पोस्टंस बट आई शुड टेक वन और टू मोर। व्हाट आर द अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू डू प्राइवेट क्लिनिकल प्रैक्टिस पेट हॉस्पिटल इन पेट हॉस्पिटल?
I will answer this. You know, this is from my personal experience. I guess the private practicing is going to boom in this uncertain times of COVID. It is a one sector where I have seen, you know, things going, you know, beyond boundaries is the pup acquisition. Everyone of my friend, every neighborhood is approaching me, sir, I want to buy a puppy. Can you give the testimonial, this is a right puppy. This puppy acquisition has happened so rampantly, and the companion animal concept is really setting up in this metro world and metro cities of the country. I'm telling you, this private practicing is going to boom, you know, in the coming years. You must have some, you know, courage to sustain, to face the initial challenges, and then you will see the, you know, benefits, and you will reap the benefits. Dr. Neela, you would like to add?
Yeah, very, very true, Dr. Naveen. And I would also like to share one of my experience when you talk about private practice. When I had started my career first time in Delhi with Indo Biocare, and it was not such a high remuneration starting job, and I had to put up in Delhi. So I took a special approval from the MD that in the evening, after my job is over, can I go and work in a private clinic? And I was into the pet division, and that was a clinic. So one of the doctors was interested, and I used to go to east of Kailash in the evening clinic. And it was such an enriching experience. On Sundays, he used to call me to the clinic. And then I understood what great opportunities these canine practicing clinics have. Now, if you go to Mumbai, they are expert in reptiles. There are a section of practitioners in reptiles. And the opportunities are immense, actually, in private practicing clinics. And what you are seeing in Delhi, the way earlier the clinics were not so much pet clinics in Bihar, but in UP, and in all these places now I see that many new clinics are coming up, many new veterinarians are making a new beginning. So really the opportunities are very much there.
Thank you, Dr. Neela. One more question, I think this is pertinent to you. In between, our respected director researcher Praveen Kumar sir has joined this interaction. So I welcome our respected director researcher for gracing this occasion. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, being part of this one. One more question, Nilay. Dr. Ajit, I think this is from final year. How you first failure of your life and how to resolve it?
See, first you have to understand that the thing which you are doing is your liking. It has to be your passion. So when it gets tough or when it gets a kind of failure, then you don't give up. You try other way to approach towards your goal in a different way. So when I was into sales, I realized over a period of time that no, as Dr. Naveen was telling some time back, that it's a very good combination if you have a sales experience and you try to jump into marketing and you get into marketing. So, before I joined the marketing product management, I was not doing very good in sales. And during those times, I had interaction with Dr. Naveen also. We were both in Ranbaxy when I used to come to there, and we used to talk a lot. So that failure, and when I developed a product in vet care, that too failed. But a few of those succeeded as well. So it has to be taken as a part of your life. It's not the end of the, don't say that what you did after your first failure, it was not a big event. I tried to learn something out of it and didn't try to get my eyes off or try to feel it as a bad memory or something. You have to keep it in your mind. Okay, we did something like this and it went on wrong. So this is the don'ts which I learned from here. And next time onward, any successful person in the eyes of the society will try to do that. That, okay, we don't repeat this mistake. If it is in your mind, you will not do it again.
Thank you, Nila, for honest answer. And I must repeat your words. So no failure is permanent until unless you keep trying.
From your guidance. Exactly.
There are many questions going on. So I will be collecting these questions and will be forwarding to you. And with your permission and Naveen's permission, I will be sharing your email and contact address so that our alumni, our students can interact with
you. Please, sir. Please, sir. We are giving our consent.
And if the situation permits, we'll be organizing offline meeting as well. I think they will be very happy to interact with you one-to-one, personal-to-personal. Because we have limitations of time, so I request, I will be just binding this one. And with this, I will request our respected Dean, sir, to have some observatory remarks, visionary Dean, sir. I think both of you must be knowing because you are in clinical side and sir is from gynecology. So please, sir, your objective remarks on this.
Thank you very much, Dr. Pankaj, Honorable Vice Chancellor of this prestigious institute, Dr. Rameshwar Singh, DRI cum Dean PGS, Dr. Veer Singh, Director Research, Dr. Ravindra Kumar, and very dear alumni of Bihar Veterinary College, and today's speaker, Dr. Nilay and Dr. Naveen Kumar, faculty members, and my dear students. Our both these speakers today spoke about very much closely related topic, that is job uncertainty vis-a-vis avenues. And sir, I can say that you have encouraged our students for their bright future, and this could be done in a better way, by none other than our alumni. So thank you very much. Today's speaker are very much successful in their respective fields. This is because of their hard work in all the situations of their career. And I'd like to say a few lines because our Dr. Pankaj has just energized me for the few lines for our speakers. Wah path kya, pathik kushalta kya, jis path par bikhre phool na ho, नाविक की धैर्य कुशलता क्या यदि धाराएं प्रतिकूल न हो. तो आप लोगों ने बहुत सी एडवर्स सिचुएशंस में, बहुत कठिन परिस्थितियों में भी काम किया है, एंड सर्टेनली नाउ वी आर सक्सेसफुल. एज स्टेटेड बाय आवर स्पीकर, लार्जेस्ट डेयरी फार्म ऑफ द कंट्री इज बीइंग रन बाय नॉन वेटनेरियन. सो इफ व्हाट आई थिंक दैट इफ वेट्स विल बी इन्वॉल्व इन दिस फील्ड, सर्टेनली दे विल डू बेटर, बेटर प्रोग्रेस कुड बी मेड. Yes, maybe failure, but certainly it's temporary. The only and only requirement is think with a positive way, do in a positive way, and certainly you can get success. But I feel that on campus, our students always dream to shape their future in a better way with the inspiration of our successful alumni. And today, both of you really motivated our students. So I thank again to Dr. Nilay and Dr. Naveen for their inspirational thoughts. Thank you very much. Now over to Dr. Pankaj.
Thank you very much, sir. Always positive, full of positivity. And I'm very much thankful to you. In between, respected Director Research has graced this occasion. Sir, please, I request you to have few words of blessings for our participants, and I must say these are successful entrepreneurs, but still are your students and your I must say junior most students. successful position. So please, sir, your God's blessings for them and our participants and our students. Honorable Dr. Rishas, Dr. Ravinder Kumar, sir. Sir, mute.
Thank you very much, Dr. Pankaj. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Rameshwar Singhji, Dr. Veer Singh, Dean PGS, Dr. J.K. Prashad, Dean BVC. Our guest speakers of the day, Dr. Naveen and Dr. Nilay Prashad, and our faculty colleagues and students. In fact, I'm sorry to my guest speakers that I missed your talk. I could join at the fag end. I was busy somewhere else. And I'm trying to join in between, but due to some other serious thing going on, I couldn't join. But anyway, I just like to convey my thanks and regards on behalf of students of this college, who shall be highly indebted to you for delivering a motivated talk to them. In fact, this COVID situation has given us an opportunity to arrange some such motivational talks, and they do need such motivational talks when they are some sort of greater stress during this period. And as Dr. Pankaj said, that we like to have one-to-one meeting of you people with our students and faculty members. So as soon as the situation normalizes, I'd love you to be on our campus and have a one-to-one interaction. And I hope you'll be spared some time for this interaction. So now, without taking much of time, I thank you. My guest speakers and all the officers and other participants. Thank you, Dr. Perkins.
Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words and for motivating us at all platforms. I think this is now high time to request our Honorable Vice Chancellor Rameshwar Singh sir and his visionary and I think founder Vice Chancellor, who has given the shape of this university. Because sir, koi jane ya na jane, jo ye do humare speaker hain, ye 94-95 mein yahan se sir pass out kiye hain, aur main ek bar sir inko video dikha raha tha, to Dr. Nilay bhai surprised ki sir ab aisa ho gaya. तो सर क्रेडिट गोज टू यू सर. और एक सर एक लाइन जो अभी बड़ा अच्छा नवीन ने कहा कि हम कॉलेज से तो निकल जाते हैं, कॉलेज हमसे कभी नहीं निकलता. दिस हार्ट टचिंग वर्ड्स जो है सर, ये बात सही है कि हम कॉलेज से तो पास आउट होके निकल जाते हैं, ये कॉलेज हमारा नहीं छोड़ता. अगर हमारा कॉलेज हमारा यूनिवर्सिटी अच्छा रह रहा है तो सर इसके जो जितने भी कंट्रीब्यूटर हैं उनको हैट्स ऑफ. और उनकी तरफ से भी सर प्लीज योर प्रेसिडेंशियल रिमार्क्स ऑन दिस ओकेजन प्लीज सर. दिस इज
थैंक यू डॉक्टर पंकज. डियर कोलीग्स, एस्टीम्ड स्पीकर्स, faculty, students, and other participants. I was listening to the talks delivered by Dr. Nilay and Dr. Naveen, and they were very useful in many aspects. They were speaking, you know, without any holds. They came out very openly on various points. And mentioned, you know, about the different traits which we need to develop when we are studying. One mention came that students in Western countries, they pay for their, they earn for their fees themselves by working, you know, when they are studying. In fact, after say 12 or 14 years of age, they start working. I met a guy, very senior person, who is settled in US now, and his children have been brought up there. So he said, my daughter appeared for interview for a waiter in a restaurant, and that's how she will learn, you know, interaction. She will learn communication skills. She will learn, you know, the kind of confidence. And she will also learn the value for your time and your work. No work is small, and there is no attitude that does not work. So this entrepreneur skills and many other skills which are required in day-to-day life, they come with the kind of more and more exposure you have. If you strictly remain, you know, confined to your class and you to your college, you will miss many other traits and you may not be able to discover your own self. So that is the message which has come today, and whenever we talk to entrepreneurs and people from industry, they underline all these traits. Our teachers also must behave more like mentors. They must cultivate this relationship with the students of a mentor and a student can be influenced in many ways, what to read, to look for, in further career, like that. So we are continuing with this series of lectures and this two-day program of 3rd and 9th. Today has comes to an end. Today also there were many questions, and the kind of interest generated has been worth noticing. So we will do more such activities and do more on the campus when the situation improves. Now we are reopening slowly, and going to unlock the economic activity and other activities, and especially the teaching activities. Schools and colleges have remained closed for a pretty long time now, and in a phased manner we will start the reopening process. Regarding this entrepreneurship, we have to innovate, do some different things, new things. I was reading one quote from Albert Einstein, who said, if you always do what you always did, you will always get what you always got. So you have to change and do new things. So that is the take-home message for the faculty as well as students. So whatever role you are, you must innovate, you must try to do something more, something new to improve things. And I'm happy that a good number of participants have continued with the meeting and benefited themselves. So I congratulate the organizers and thank all of you, all the participants from outside also, and all the students for joining. Have a nice time. And I conclude with my thanks to the speakers and thanks to all the participants. All the best.
Thank you very much, sir. There is no scope of vote of thanks after your speech, sir. So thank you again and again to my speakers, Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, Dr. Rishad, sir, Professor Veer Singh, ICOM Dean PG, sir, Dean, sir, and our beloved students, Mr. Satya, PRO, who is taking care of all activities, online activities. And again and again, many, many thanks to our speaker, Dr. Naveen, Dr. Nile, and in glasses, session, Dr. Tanvi Alama, Anand Madhav, and to all our alumni for your love, for your affection, and for your bonding, for your alumni, for your college, and for ourselves. So thank you very much. Thank you very much to one and all. We will again meet. And sir, I'm happy to share that 187 participants have registered from Gujarat, as well as from Rajasthan, from Assam, because it was plotted on the Facebook. So it is good number. And I'm sure most of all must have benefited from this. So we'll be meeting again with the new venture, with new topic, so that our students can get motivated. And thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable time, for your guidance and everything. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks to Dr. Pankaj also for nice organization.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. With this, in this session, stay safe, stay healthy, and get connected. Thank you, Nila.